أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وآله الأطيبين، والسلام على أصحابه الغر الميامين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري، واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد، respected scholars, brothers and sisters in Islam, سلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Do you need the field to wash your hands again and again? Do you need to repeat your prayers time and again? And do you think that they have somehow become invalid? Do you have inappropriate thoughts about God, about religion, and about prominent social and religious figures? Do these ideas haunt you? Do you need to make the wudu time and again because you think you somehow invalidated it? Do you feel that you have become contaminated or najis or impure? And does it occupy most of your time, or does it cause you significant anxiety? If your answer to those questions was yes, and if your response upon hearing them was yes, that's me, then this video is for you, and nevertheless for all the mu'mineen, because a problem, an important issue, religious OCD, obsessive-compulsive disorder, haunts our youth and our society. In secret, because the problem is the sufferers of OCD feel too ashamed and embarrassed to talk about it. Nevertheless, we should take care of our brothers in Islam, our sisters in Islam, and people in general who are suffering from religious OCD. First of all, let me tell you, you're not alone. There's a community of OCD sufferers that suffer from OCD and whom this disease, this disorder, this mental illness haunts. Let me tell you that although it may seem far-fetched, but cure is possible. And the good news is, it's not very far. It's a step away. Inshallah, we shall be discussing what is the religious view on religious OCD. The most common question we get is this the waswasa of shaitan? That the answer to that is not so straightforward, but I would not entirely put it on shaitan, honestly. Because the science today, although there are some narrations that say somebody who has kathir al-shak, who is kathir al-shak, who has excessive doubt. But when we talk of OCD, it is far beyond kathir al-shak. Yes. The impact that shaitan can have in your life is not this much. And this type of disease, disorder cannot be cured only by dua. It is a well-defined and recognized mental disorder, just like any disease. You cannot recite Surah Al-Hamd on a broken bone and it will heal. Rather, you have to go to an expert, you have to go to a doctor, then you have to pray for shifa. Inshallah, that's what is my first advice. Don't shy away from going to a psychiatrist. If the parents, if the elders of our community are listening to this video, please. Mental illnesses are a serious problem. We are the people who stigmatize these mental illnesses, especially such issues such as depression and anxiety and OCD. And then we are the ones who issue a fatwa when somebody is on the brink of suicide, and we blame them for not having tawakkal in Allah. Wallahi, it's only them who know what they are going through. It kills them every day, every second, to live with this disorder. Kindly, if your child walks up to you, if your brother, your sister, your wife, your spouse, your father, your mother tells you that they are not feeling well, they need to see a psychiatrist, please take this seriously. Don't let the stigma betray you. Don't let it take away your loved ones from you, or at least don't let it take their life from you. Yes, and from them as well. We need to understand that these issues are of utmost importance. And the number two question we get is, we have some inappropriate thoughts about religious figures and God, and we have fears that we may have committed blasphemy, or that our faith is somehow compromised. So what should we do, and are such thoughts haram? Number one, take it from me, I guarantee you these thoughts are not haram, even if you think, and I know what kind of thoughts you have, I know, wallahi, but even if you think they are deliberate, they're not haram. From a faqhi and jurisprudential point of view, they're not haram. Yes. This is the most common question and the most common problem that sufferers from religious OCD have, that they have a certain thought, then they need to do a ritual. For example, one person I was talking to would recite salawat 10 times or a certain number of times every time he or she had a thought. Yes. You don't need to do that. You don't need to ask for forgiveness. God is already pleased with you. Don't worry about it. This does not displease him. This is not disapproved. This is not haram for you. Don't worry about it. Even if you think it's deliberate, don't worry about it. Thirdly, don't think you are alone in the struggle. There are thousands of people suffering from the same disorder, having the same symptoms and signs you have. And inshallah, we are here for you. Everybody is ready to help you. Don't worry about it. Fourthly, there are questions regarding other issues such as contamination and prayer and wudu. But they are sometimes objective and different to different people. And if you want them answered, I would be more than happy to answer you from an OCD perspective and from a religious perspective. What is the ruling, for example, in a particular issue? For example, will this thing become najis like this, or will my wudu become invalid like this? Questions like such. Or I have a particular thought, it's bothering me, is it haram? Although I said it's not haram in general, these thoughts are not haram, and I know what kind of thoughts we are talking about, but trust me, they're not haram from a jurisprudential point of view. Allah loves you, don't worry about it. Yes, it is just that your OCD is shielding your consciousness and your thought processing, and you're not able to process these things. And I understand, and I understand how difficult it is for you to speak up, but nevertheless, it's important to seek help, to seek professional help. Don't let somebody deceive you, tell you that you don't have iman. Wallahi, I've seen cases of OCD, they go to a religious personality, they go to a cleric, they tell him that you don't have iman. Wallahi, that is not the case. That is not the case. That is never ever the case. OCD, although its roots are unknown, is a well-defined mental disorder and needs professional help. Don't shy away and feel free to ask questions about it. I mean the religious side of it. If you have a particular ruling, as you said, you want to know about, kindly let me know in the comments. I would be more than happy to answer you, to help you through it. Inshallah, and we pray for all our brothers around the world, all our sisters around the world suffering from this chronic disorder. May Allah give them shifa al-kamil and ajil. May Allah hasten their shifa, inshallah ta'ala. And finally, I'd like to tell you, don't be an OCD sufferer, be a fighter. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.